Today, the demo is about creating a declarative agent with an API plugin. And this demo is part of a series of labs that we have in the Copilot Developer Camp, which is a set of videos and then some labs that you can go through to learn how to extend Copilot, whether you are a maker or a professional developer. And here and in the chat, you can find the link to the Copilot Dev Camp. The Copilot Dev Camp gives you content about different scenarios, like if you want to be a maker and wear the hat of maker, you can learn how to extend Copilot using the Copilot Studio Builder or the Copilot Studio, or how to create SharePoint agents. And if you want to wear the hat of a developer, you might want to extend Copilot leveraging the foundational model and the orchestrator of Microsoft 365 Copilot. And as such, you want to go through the declarative agent path E, which stands for extend. Or if you want to rely on a fully custom foundational model and you want to have your own orchestrator, you will end up digging into the custom engine agent learning pathway, which is called B because it stands for build. Today, we are in the E path, so we are going to extend Microsoft 365 Copilot. When you go through the Copilot Dev Camp, you can also claim a badge if you complete the pathway. So we have the three pathways, and whenever you will complete each of them, you will be able to claim a badge, which mimics the judo belt right now. So it will be the blue belt for the make, extend, and build path. If you will be able to complete all of them, you will become a master and you will get a black belt. And if you will also share your knowledge with the community and with the sample in the community sample gallery, you will get a red belt for the sensei. And keep into account that this initiative will end on May the 20th, and it will target only the very first 200 community members who will earn badges. So that's it. If you want to dig more in the Copilot Dev Camp, there is also a video that I recorded something like 10 days ago or so. And if you go at this URL, you can learn all of the stuff that you can dig into while going through the Copilot Dev Camp. That said, let's talk about the capability to consume an external API from an agent in Copilot. And basically, think about this scenario. An end user will send a prompt, will ask a question to Microsoft 365 Copilot. And by default, Copilot can rely on the semantic index for Copilot and on the content that you have on your own Microsoft 365 tenant. However, if you create a custom agent, like for example, a declarative agent, you can add an API plugin extension to your agent, and you can make it possible for the agent to consume an external API, a REST API, in a secure way, secured with Entra ID, so that you will be able on the REST API side to get access to the user identity, to the user who is interacting with Copilot in the front end of the solution. And you will be able to provide functionalities like querying data or even updating data or executing actions using post or put REST requests for your API. This is a really powerful scenario, in my opinion, because you can add advanced functionalities to your agents and make Copilot for Microsoft 365 even richer and more complete from an end user point of view. So now let's move to the requirements that you have to satisfy in order to create such a solution and in order to consume an API plugin. You need specifically for the demo we are going through to have Node.js version 20. You need to have Visual Studio Code and the Teams Toolkit. The Azure Functions for VS Code, because the solution we are going to see is a solution that relies on an Azure function created in VS Code. And you will run the solution on your own environment if you will go through the same lab on your own machine. And also the Azure Storage Explorer, or at least the emulator, if you want to run it locally on your machine, you just need to use the emulator and you don't need the real Azure Storage one. So that said, here is the demo. I will pass it to Bob, who recorded it. And please give me a feedback in case of any issue with the audio, but you should be able to listen also to the audio recorded by Bob. So enjoy the demo.
Well, thanks, and let's get started. I'm going to begin by skipping the install and jumping right into where we download the application. Now, this was created using Teams Toolkit, beginning with an agent, a declarative agent with an API. And it created the Azure Functions, and then I added a lot more to the Azure Functions, including this whole simulated consulting company scenario. So to save all that work, you're just going to download the working solution or the beginning of the solution right here. And this is what it's going to look like. You'll go into the lab solution folder and copy that into your working location. And then let's open that up with Visual Studio Code. And we've already installed Teams Toolkit, Node.js. Of course, I trust the authors. And I just have to make a little adjustment to the environment files. Specifically, it needs the location of the storage connection string, and that's going to point to some local storage just using the Azure storage simulator. So now I'll do an npm install, which is just a one-time thing, and that will load the all the packages that we need. And then let's go ahead and make sure we're logged into Teams Toolkit. We are, so I will debug this. So everything else is ready to go in this solution, and I sped things up a little bit in the video, but we're going to come right into Copilot, and I'm not going to log in right now. I'm going to minimize that, and instead, I want to actually take a look at the API. So there's an HTTP file here, and I can click one of the requests and look for /me, and you'll see that for the moment, it thinks that I'm Avery Howard, which is a test user. We'll fix that in one of the future labs to be demonstrated on May 13th. And now let's take a look at Azure. So I'm just going to bring up the Storage Explorer and show you that all that same information that the API returned is actually being stored inside of Azure Table Storage. So there are three tables, a consultant table, projects table, and an assignments table, which has the assignments between the consultants and their projects. And you can actually go in there and it will persist the data, and you can even update the data or put in your own sample data if you wish. So I'd like to take a moment and talk about some API design considerations. This is unofficial, but based on my experience in playing around with Copilot and building this and other samples. The first thing is to think about, do you need the whole API? Maybe you want to limit the surface area that you're going to allow AI to go ahead and do operations on. It also helps if you use intuitive names in the paths, parameters, and payloads. In a lot of APIs, it doesn't really matter because everything is coded. But in this case, an artificial intelligence is going to try to understand your API. So keep it intuitive if you can, and name things with logical names. Now, it's best if you start with use cases rather than just an arbitrary API. What is it that you want the user to be able to do using Copilot? And then allow each one of those use case intents to be satisfied with a single HTTP request. Currently, Copilot will not string together multiple requests, say, get an ID for something, and then issue a second request using that ID. You need for everything to be in one request, and this API will even take partial parameters. So if you ask for Avery's projects, for instance, it will find all the Avery's. You don't have to go look up the Avery user ID and then go look up the projects. Finally, it's better not to expect Copilot to filter data. Instead, provide parameters that do the filtering server side. That's always a good idea anyway. To expose this in Copilot, we're going to have to put together an application package, which is a bunch of JSON files and a couple of icons, all zipped into a zip archive. The manifest tells Copilot that there's an application and gives basic information, and then the declarative agent plugin and OpenAPI definition files provide all the information about what the declarative agent is supposed to do and how to call the API. So let's have a look at that. I'm going to open up the app package folder, and we'll start with manifest.json. Every Teams application and Copilot agent has one of these files. And you can see here that there's a Copilot agents section that declares this declarative agent and points to the declarative agent.json file. So let's open that up and have a look. And in here we have a lot of details, including detailed instructions. And the lab instructions, if you do the hands-on lab, will lead you through creating all of this. I'm just avoiding, because I only have 10 minutes, all the copying and pasting that you would have to do. One thing to notice about the instructions is that it's giving the declarative agent an idea of what it's supposed to do. And it also has some special instructions. One you might want to notice is that it should always remind users of the Tray Research motto, which is always be billing. Next, we have the conversation starters. And these are the prompt suggestions that are displayed to the user when they start using the declarative agent. Next, we have capabilities. And there's one here, which is the capability of reaching into OneDrive and SharePoint and getting all the documentation about these projects. So the lab would have led you through creating that SharePoint site and uploading the documents and putting the URL into an environment variable so it can be inserted here. Finally, we have actions, and this is where we reference the API via the API plugin file. So let's have a look at that. The plugin file is specific to Copilot, and it includes functions, which are the various types of actions that Copilot can take using the API. At this point, it can get information about me, that is the current user, about other consultants, and it can bill a project on behalf of a consultant. And we'll add more to that in the next lab. The plugin file also includes additional information, including authentication information, which is specific to Microsoft 365. It also references an open API definition file, or Swagger file. So let's look at that. Now, this is a standard open API definition file that you may have seen in other applications, and they wanted to stick to the standard here. You'll see all the different paths, all the different gets and responses, what the payloads look like, even the error condition. If we get back an error, what should we do? If we get a 404, that means that we couldn't find that particular consultant, for instance. And this API also supports a post in order to build data. Now let me run the application, and I'm going to show the log file down at the bottom so you can see what's going on. I'll just pick one of the standard prompts and look for consultants with TypeScript skills. And you'll see that we have a get for slash API slash consultants. And it has a query string parameter looking for TypeScript skills. And as you can see, it found two consultants. And it did remember to put the company motto, always be billing, in the response. So now let's try another request. This time I'm going to look for some information from the documentation in SharePoint. So I want details from the statement of work and the current status, which is going to come from the API. And it called the API, as you can see from the log file, and there's the information. The details are in the response, but we can also click on that and get to the Word document itself if we want to check that attribution. Finally, let's do a post request. So I'm going to bill my hours because that's what they want me to do, is bill my hours, right? So what we're going to see next is called a confirmation card. And that is kind of a rule whenever Copilot might update some data using a post. It always checks with the user. And I clicked confirm, so you can see down at the bottom that it actually did the post. So now my hours are billed and my boss is happy. And back to the rest of the show. Well, thanks, and let's get...
Wonderful. So thank you. Thank you, Bob, and I hope you enjoyed. Back to you, Vesa.